on both sides. The concrete mixer's there, the truck's there. I should put the concrete mixer there. And that way I just piss hand it off onto the truck, into the mixer, and then turn the mixer around and shovel it off. Let's do that.
It's also easier to put a rock on it so you don't have to chase these around. I learned that too. If I put a rock on it, I don't have to chase those around.
Daffodiller. Thank you.
I missed my mark. Let's see if we can tap that in. Tried to pound it out, but I just cut it off instead of trying to pound it out. Got caps in here and these. I'm gonna put a block out here. Yeah, you'll see. We'll check this. I glued those caps in. Leo, 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 you come to bury a treasure? Come, go bury some treasures, buddy. All right, I think we're good. It sat overnight. So. That's one thing right there, but I don't see any other wet spots. Slopes pretty good, 1/4 inch per foot. You don't want any more, you don't want any less.
really try to get it pretty close to that. Otherwise, solids, liquids, they move just right at 1/4 inch per foot. I'll have to check that one. I don't know what that one is. But, yeah. I've been watering her for a while. It won't take much more. A lot of that is sand. The fine's all washed up, but it's compacting. I compacted it and then water packed it. It's just wet sand right now. That'll seep down, blow off, harden up. I didn't want any voids, you know, so I just flooded it, put some more pipes in too. Here's my utility room. These will be outside the wall. Maybe that 2 inch will be inside the wall.
This one is level.
And level and square with the string line. I've got this on the string line, but that one needs to be set about even with the string line. So I've got that string line jacked out a little bit on these corners. That's how I'm gonna do them. And then all the weld pads will get these down through there. I don't know if I'm going to put a bolt on there. I may or may not put a nut on there. But again, I'm using the laser level for level. and the string line for straight, because it's still off. I've tightened the fire out of it and it's still off about a half inch, the string line. So, and then I've got a generator, 7,000 watt, and my welder. It works good. MIG, I'm doing MIG gas. This is my welding cart. So, that's what I'm doing. Let's weld this up. I had a little bit off here and here. But I'm pretty happy with all the other ones. I was wanting to weld up these off three sides, but or two sides. Looking good. You can kind of see where the panels are going to be, how many panels I got. 16 foot will be the biggest one. I don't know what to show.
It don't matter to us.
It doesn't matter, you guys?
No, not really. Go ahead, Alan. Let's go.
Okay.
getting back. I don't want that falling on me. Ankle breaker. That's how the pros do it. Okay, I'm good. Screed boards, I'm almost done. I've got to put a little plastic here. I'll have to run and get a piece. I'm gonna use screed boards, 10 foot, and screed it out off the tops. Off the tops of the boards and then the screed pins. I'll just slide the board down. And then I'll pull these pins out. We'll be done. I gotta put a pin right there.
Yeah, I'll put the screed here, like this. I'm gonna screed this part, and then move over there. Okay. You don't see that? Go get this. Who's gonna run the shooting?
Right.
This is why I'm using the rifle.
What most companies don't do the...
No, they're in the back.
It shoots in the back.
Oh. That's what you can shoot up. Also, what they do is they try to put some rubber down.
is that the
gallons, well, gallons of water.
Oh, I know.
It's a half a slot per 5 gallons. So it's a six slot. Should be coming up to 6.5. So that's all that. That's what the 5 is. All right, I'm going to do this deal. We'll start on this bay.
Okay.
Yeah, don't overwork yourself.
Uh-oh. All that vaping makes me not breathe as good. Thank you.
wait a little longer.
Feeling too wet right here.
I got sand in it.
Tomorrow. I'm leaving it. This power trowel had holes in it and it was cutting in. Look at that. It's a rental. It was cutting in. They're all just razor sharp. That one is especially. So is that one. But it's good enough. It ain't perfect. There's a few rough spots. But it's pretty smooth like that. A few rough spots, but it's certainly flat. I thought I was going to lose it because of that blade cutting in, but I was able to save it. There's going to be a wall here, so I wasn't too worried about the edges. They still look pretty good. Yeah, it looks good. Concrete's hard when everything goes right, which it usually doesn't. It's hard when it goes right, and the power trowel failing is definitely... I guess that's on me. I saw a little hole in it when I rented it. That was my foolishness, but I don't know any better. I'm not skilled enough to know, oh, hey, this ain't gonna work. Now I know. I didn't know before, now I know. Yeah. There's a few spots that are a little bit rough, but it is certainly flat. All right, that's the job. Turned out pretty good. I'm not gonna finish it anymore. That's about the type of finish I have on the other floor. Not pretty smooth, but not super, super smooth. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with the job. 5.5 slump was the magic slump for it. Looser than that, I developed shrinkage cracks. So 5.5 slump would have been the best slump for the whole thing. But it's a lot harder when you do a 5.5 slump. Me and another guy, it's just hard to move that stuff around. It turned out pretty good. There's a few low spots, but you can see it's pedaling up pretty flat. I mean, I'm not a concrete guy, so I don't know what we're gonna do on finishes on the inside yet. We may grind it down and have a polished concrete, make it look like terrazzo flooring, you know, grind it down to the rock. Or we may put carpet in the bedrooms, flooring, I don't know yet. That's not a problem I gotta worry about today. Next process will be the walls. There's a method to my madness on building it. I want to grout in these edges. I'll set the panel on top, grout it in, and then once that I'm done with all the panels, I'll probably grout these edges with a flowable grout and get in all the spots in there, fill them up. That way the panels can't ever come down on each other on the house. The embeds are just for setting them. And then I'll tie pieces across. Man, it's gonna be a strong house. It's definitely gonna be a strong house. All the corners in it, all the panels will be welded to each other. Probably a foot long weld on all the panels. And then they'll be grouted to each other, and then there'll be a cross member on top. Yeah, it's gonna be a strong house. Oh, why'd I come over here? I forgot why I came over here. I came to look at windows, which is my next process, is the walls. So, hope you enjoyed the video.